Welcome to another Teacher's Corner playthrough. Today we'll be playing through the vault. I am joined today by a friend of mine, Beard. Say hi, Beard.
Hello.
Are you trying to sound that way, Beard?
What way is that?
I love the way Beard's lowered his voice. Okay. So we're going to be playing the vault. You can see we're teamed up, and I am already in my shuttle. This is a shuttle mission. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and claim or start the episode. Where is it? There we go. It is in the Romulan Mystery Arc, and Admiral Tenet will tell us what to do.
The Romulans had a base known as the Vault that they used for research into Borg technology. This facility was abandoned in the chaos after the destruction of the Romulan homeworld, but intelligence suggests that the work there was far enough along that it was used to retrofit Nero's ship before it disappeared along with Ambassador Spock's vessel in the Hobus system. Long-range sensors have detected energy spikes in the Halcona system, and Starfleet intelligence believes that someone is bringing the Vault back online. We need to know who, and more importantly, we need to know if there is still Borg technology or restricted weaponry on that base. I need you to proceed immediately to the Halcona system and investigate the vault. Engage if you must, but I would prefer if you could gather the information we need without conflict.
So we speak to DeSoto for additional information. We've already gone to the shipyard aboard a shuttlecraft. To the Halcona system, hopefully that will. Nope, looks like we do have to go down and speak to Lieutenant DeSoto in the Admiral's office in Starbase 39. So we're transwarping there. The fun part, all the traveling around from here to there, right? I love when you transwarp and it doesn't put you exactly where you need. There we go. I look like a pet next to this big old cruiser here. Alright. Beaming down to Sierra 39. Now I need to find Lieutenant Commander DeSoto in the Admiral's office. Now the question is, where is the Admiral's office? Oh yeah, it's up here. Can you tell it's been a while since I played these? There we go, take the turbo. No, that's not it. Okay, where is... Okay, that's Admiral DeSoto. Nope, that's Tenet. Okay, found him. In order to avoid drawing too much notice, you need to fly under the radar, so to speak. Admiral Tenet has authorized the requisition of a shuttlecraft for you. You can fulfill the requisition in the shipyard once you're ready. Take the shuttlecraft out to the Halcona system. If you have a runabout fighter or other such craft available, feel free to use it, but do not approach the system in a starship. We want to avoid the notice of whoever's in the vault. A shuttlecraft will also be able to dock with the vault and explore the interior. Beard, are you starting a party over there?
I started since we entered the room.
Okay. So we have no more questions. And very well, remember, you must use a shuttlecraft, runabout, or fighter, or slimmer, small craft, to undertake this mission. We need on-site intel from the interior of the vault. Starfleet will not clear you to enter the Hakona system otherwise. Good luck. So we need to head down to the shipyard. And there we go. Alright, size doesn't matter. That's our accolade. See, we keep telling you guys that, but you don't listen. Okay. My dude was clapping when he came down. Shipyard! Okay, I haven't been here in a while. I believe the shipyard's this way, yep. Beard remembers where it is. Is it true, Beard, this is your favorite mission?
Yeah.
Makes you feel any better, I like it about as much as you do. Something about it, I don't know what it is. Requisition officer. So you need to speak to the requisition officer. And we only want small craft, so I'm going to go ahead and eliminate the rest of these. And the Type B shuttle is available. That you claim that to progress the mission, even if you have another shuttle, which I do. I am in the Yellowstone runabout. Beard setting up party balls again. Gotta love it. Okay. Shuttle information officer. Who are we supposed to speak with here? Okay. It's telling me I have to speak with the shuttle information officer.
Over here, the kitty cat's up. There's a couple of kitties talking to each other.
Okay. Beard, you're scaring me.
You have to go around
there's
the table.
A, yeah, there's. A, oh, okay, there he is.
They see me.
It's, there's yes, the kitty I see cat.
It. Doesn't okay. even give it a name. Just call it shuttle
there
information.
I know, right?
Cryptic is so good at making names for these people.
Yep. I can provide you with the necessary information on shuttles in general, so feel free to ask whatever you want. Okay, so we have to come around and talk to the kitty cat. Okay. And that's it. No need for anything else. We're gonna exit. Alright, so now we need to go to the Hakona system. We can beam up from here. Do-do-do. Okay. We do not want to beam down to the station. We want to leave the system and go to Hakona. Alright, so let's find Hakona on our mini map. Oh, that's all the way across the sector. Of course!
And when you had to travel like 10 different maps to get there.
Oh yeah, I remember.
And now it's right next to the vault. The vault is right next to Battle Group Omega.
Yep, I can say it is definitely much better since they took down the sector walls. Now you just have the quadrant walls. That is much, much better. Beard is outrunning me. How are you doing that? Are you using Borg engines?
No.
Why did you do to outrun?
My strands warp is 30.
Okay.
Uh-oh, better get Mako.
Put points into driver coil. The old driver coil. One of the things that happens when you use your Captain Transwarp is it will forget where it's supposed to stop. So you have to monitor it. Okay. And enter Hakona system. Obviously, this station isn't as abandoned as Intel suspected. Sensors are reading several Riemann ships in the area, and that's just the ones that we can spot. That station is immense! It must have taken an incredible amount of manpower and technology to build it. It's almost the size of a small moon! Sensors are reading a sophisticated tachyon detection network, as well as several patrolling vessels. Sir, for an abandoned station, this facility is certainly has a lot of activity. The Romulans are experts at stealth technology. If we want to approach unseen, we must avoid confrontation and find a way to evade or jam their sensor grid. We must assume that if we engage the ships here, they'll notify whoever is left on the station, and it may become difficult to find an entry point. So avoid patrol vessels and evade sensor nets while approaching the vault. Consult with your officers for options. So this is one where we need to, so we can choose either to disable some communication satellites, use a derelict ship, okay, we might find some helpful clues there, or what else we got? We could use some stellar debris, okay, engineering officers can scan the large asteroid. And, or we can use the nebula. This is the option, the best option usually. But we can use our nebula. We'll disrupt your shields and sensors, but we might offer an alternative way to sneak in. This is the one I've always had the most success with. So we can go to the nebula, which is of course right in front of us.
So if you're going for stealth, why'd you fly right into the horns?
I didn't see him. It's my own fault. I didn't see him. Damn it. Let's try that again. So where is that nebula? I wasn't looking too close. Let's go over by B. Let's scan the asteroid. All right, here we go. Looks like the fragment has picked up a bit of residual energy from our weapons burst. It'll be radiating energy for a while. Other than that, it's just a rock. Ay. I'm not so good at this stealth thing, and this is one of the reasons I don't like this mission. I always have problems with the stealth thing.
you think.
Yep. But the good thing is they're all over that rock. So now I can fly over to the nebula. There's the nebula. Okay. The trick is getting to the nebula. And now while staying in the nebula, getting to the actual vault. And there's a tachyon detection grid. So we want to make sure we are not detected by this grid. If we follow the nebula, it's going to take us what seems to be right around it. Yay! At least through. We're in. And it looks like we weren't detected. There we go. Okay. And now we can enter the vault. Picking up some unusual energy readings. We'll need to explore the accessible interior areas and see what we can find. Looks like there's another access conduit across from us. We'll have to think three-dimensionally in here. Sensor readings are also picking up a few scattered life signs. So we're searching the vault interior for unusual readings and inhabitant. We're also looking for our temporal probe, which in here is going to be really fun to find. Alright. Now here, there is a little tip in here. If you are going with a friend, you can have your friend stay at the entrance while, or you can stay at the entrance while the other person completes it. And then when he completes it at the end, or your friend completes it at the end, you will be able to click the exit and speed up the mission a little bit. In other words, you won't have to fly back.
Where's the fun now?
Something's got me! I know. If this is your favorite mission, like it is ours. Okay, so the doors are massive. Let's try security keys. Really? You just kind of brute force your way through it. Try again. And We will try again. Current key code, okay. So we keep trying. And I just keep trying until it actually just decides to go through. Brute force, yay. Come on. This is the pain in the butt part. The other part I don't like about this mission. There we go. Got it. Okay. See? Brute force.
No, I just went to examine the containers.
And that's what did it. Okay. I'm also looking for that darn temple probe. I'm not seeing it anywhere yet. Try and avoid these little plasma arcs. In here, because you don't want to get hit by them, it will not be a good thing. Where did you find your temple probe when you did this on your temporal agent beard?
I think it was in the last room.
Alright. Still not seeing the temporal probe anywhere. Hopefully it will be in the same place Beard's. Amazing. I gotta say, it's amazing architecture. But, yeah. So, up above us is the Borg sphere, so we need to go up so we can get a scan of it. And up we go. This is what they mean by thinking three-dimensionally. There we go. Now we scan. The Borg sphere is dormant, like it's been put to sleep. It's not the source of the strange readings that long-range scans detected. Looks like the sphere's hooked into part of the local systems network. We should be able to exit through the other doors now. Probably a safety precaution to keep them locked. Alright, and other doors are this way. This way? Am I going through the right set of doors? Yep. I always end up getting turned around. Go, moving right along. Still looking for that temporal probe. Come out wherever you are. Okay, another room. Not seeing the temple probe anywhere. This is the final room, isn't it? Did you find the temporal probe, Beard? Don't want to scan that reactor until we see if we can find it. This is the final room, right?
Yeah, but it changes for different people. Someone said there was in the middle room on the north wall.
I'll have to check on our way
out. Let's see if I can find it.
Yeah. I'll go ahead and scan the Thaleron reactor. Sir, this is it. This was a weapons lab, an industrial research and fabrication facility where the Romulans built Thaleron weapons. If the Remans have infiltrated this base, they must be trying to secure those weapons.
Ah, so our intruder finally arrives at the heart of the matter. Have you seen all that you came to see, little spy?
Who are you?
Does it really matter? Call me Obasek. If a name is that important.
I went to the middle room looking.
Okay. What are you doing here?
That should be obvious. I intend to make use of the station to further my agenda. Your presence, however, is a bit more curious. I expect that you are operating under the shroud of Empress Sela, whether you realize it or not.
I'm here to investigate unusual scanner readings from this station.
Doubtless you have discovered the source of those readings. Understand that I have little desire to unleash this sort of destruction, but my hand is forced. The Reman people will only be liberated if we are able to make a clear and decisive stand against the Romulans. The technology of this station will allow us to do so.
The Federation could assist the Remans in their desire to be separate from the Romulan people.
Just as your Federation offered assistance to the Romulans before the supernova of Hobus and the subsequent destruction of Romulus? No. History has shown that I cannot trust in the good intentions of the Federation. An oppressed people must be ready to seize their liberty through any means available to them. The technology of this station has provided me with indisputable means.
Even if you succeed, you must find a way to normalize relations. You will need allies.
I will deal with the future when it arrives. For me, there is no tomorrow until my people are free. However, I respect your commitment to your position. It's a shame we are at cross purposes. I am afraid our time is at an end. My associates have already finished loading the Thaleron weapons that we need, and I have other operations to manage. I think we both know what happens now. May your death be quick and valorous.
All right. And we're killing the scorpion fighter. Get them all? I think I got some all. Any luck finding that probe? Alrighty. Let's do a thorough look around, make sure I didn't miss it in here. Looking all around, I do not see it anywhere. Come out, wherever you are. Any luck, Beard, in the other room? Okay, let's see. Maybe it's in the middle room. I'm looking all around. I don't see it anywhere in here. Any luck at all, Beard, finding the probe? It is vague as heck. It just says it's somewhere in the Hakona system. It doesn't show up until you're actually inside the vault. Okay. Things don't even show up on my sensors. There we go. Still don't see the probe anywhere. Up here.
Warning, ship is under attack.
Any luck at all?
Ship is under attack.
You there, Beard?
No, there's nothing up here. Just in here waiting.
Okay. I'm not finding it at all anywhere.
It might be in the first room. I was reading a website. It came to like three or four different locations.
Yeah. Okay, well, we'll find it. I am scouring, as this playthrough will show. Scouring every possible location. Going at half speed through the dang place. Not seeing anything. I didn't see anything when I was up at the sphere. Seeing anything. Oh, what's this? That is another shuttle. Yeah, I'm not seeing. Anything in here. That points to a temporal probe anywhere.
I went to that room several times. Has to be in the main room.
Yeah.
If it's in this game.
Well, from what I see, it should be in here because it popped up when we entered the inside of the vault, so.
We'll just scour the entire vault.
Yep, no problem. Not seeing it.
Hull integrity below 75%.
It's not anywhere in here. So it gets me. I mean, everything in this, because it's enclosed. Especially in the hallways. If it was in the hallways, it should be popping up on our, you know, on the sensors to let me interact with it. Come on. Seeing it anywhere.
It's here in the first room. It's directly underneath.
You found it? Okay. Now, why didn't we see it the first time?
Because we're brute forcing the door instead of looking for it.
Yeah, true. She said it's directly underneath you. You are, I'm coming here.
Yeah, no, it's directly in front of me, so I was able to get her out of where I was.
I see it. It says Ally Temple Probe. Okay, I'm closing in. We found it! Yay!
And the website I looked up, this was not one of the locations.
That's not surprising. Alright, scanning coronal distortion. Unlock temple probe! Oh, yay, the digit series thing. Jeez. All right, testing 0000, because one time Beard had that as his code.
Well, not only me. I believe a guy named Alex had it, too.
That is correct. Okay. And change digits. So one is not anywhere in the combination. Two is not anywhere in the combination. Let's see if three is anywhere in our combination. Hey, three is somewhere in our combination. Let's see if four is number one. Well, four is somewhere in our combination, but it's not the first digit. Hey, we found the first digit. It's a five.
Since it took that long, must all be
five. I know, right? Since one and two both said there were zero matches for anywhere in there, we're going to skip over them and go straight to three. All right. There we go. Hey, look at that. Five, three. And here we go. Third digit. Gonna see if it's three again. Nope. Okay. And third digit, let's see if it's four. Hey, okay. And we're on to the fourth number. Yay, we know it's not one or two. Could be a three. It's not a three. Okay, could be a four. It is not a four, could be a five. Alright, test series. Hey, we got it! Based on these records, some Nicole tried to pass themselves off as Remans in a ploy to infiltrate the ranks of the Resistance. Apparently, they had a bad run-in with Obasek, and their career as revolutionaries came to a sudden, violent end. I'm not surprised. There's no room for pretenders in Obasek's revolution. Alright, and we got some components. Yay. Alright, now we can get the flock out of here. Sir, we must stop. Sir, we must stop Obasek's ship from absconding with Thaleron weapons. We can use the dormant Romulan subspace booster satellite outside the station to send a message to Starfleet as soon as we're clear of the interior. Hello. I'm moving again. This is what happens when you forget to turn off your spam bar. It's not coming up for me. There it is. Okay. Send a message to Starfleet as soon as we're clear of the interior, but Obasek's warship will almost certainly detect us when we do. We'll have to survive long enough for reinforcements to show up so we can exit the station, and there we go. Accept the team transfer. There we go. reinforcements have arrived and you are just past and are just past that nebula. We don't have much time. We need to meet with reinforcements and stop that ship. So a rendezvous on the other side of the nebula. You can see our enemies there. Head towards the green circle to our ally. We have rendezvoused with reinforcements. We are focusing on the small craft here. And try not to get killed, as I just did. I'm dead!
Yeah, so is that DJ's battle cruiser, but it's still firing and killed me.
I know, right?
Something's bugged there. I just love cryptic humor.
I know, I think it's because we still have some small craft left. I don't know. Or is there a time limit? I always forget. No, it just says engage fighters and torps. I wonder if it's because there's some small craft left. Oh, we got an accolade. Now stop the enemy ship. Okay. Alright, and hill. That was... Yeah, goodness. That was quite an explosion, probably from the Thaleron weapons carried aboard the ship. We're going to leave the system under high warp to draw off any reinforcements that might come looking. Suggest you return to Federation space. Leave the system and return to Starbase 39 Sierra. So we continue. We can depart the system. Alrighty. Do-do-do-do-do. And here's a nice little trick. Since the starting point and the ending point are the same, we can... Stop moving! We can... Okay. Plot a course for the starting location. That's what was going on. I'm so used to it letting me warp there. I'm going to use my quantum slipstream. And Beard's going to pass me up again. Lesson here, never race Beard.
What?
I said never race Beard.
Just go on normal speed.
And that way it will stop us from... It will stop us from overshooting. Choose it again after you exit transwarp. Yay, Beard is so happy we've almost finished the vault. Enter the Sierra system. And I believe we need to debrief somebody, don't we? It's been a while.
I'll leave that to you.
Yep, debrief with DeSoto. Beam down to station. debrief, and so the Admiral's office is up here. There we go. And go talk to DeSoto. I've taken a preliminary look at your logs, and it seems that things went a bit unexpectedly. I have a feeling that this isn't the last time we'll be seeing the vault. The Riemann commander you encountered is definitely a major player in the disintegration of the Romulan Star Empire. I'm going to send the information you gathered about him over to an old colleague of mine, Dr. Maximilian Peters, for analysis. If this Riemann is a leader in their separatist movement, we'll have to deal with him again, and hopefully Dr. Peters can work up a psychological profile for him and a sociological analysis of the separatists. Our next step will be to decode the signal intelligence and go through any remnants left from the ship that was destroyed near the vault. Now that we know that the Riemanns were hoping to use Thaleron weapons, we need to figure out their target location. Right now, Starfleet knows far too little about a civil war in the making, but it will take time to sift through all of the data. Keep in touch. Starfleet will notify you when we have a lead. Oh, and thanks for the good work, Captain. Return to Admiral Tenet. Thankfully, Excellent Admiral Tenet.
We need to learn more about the conflict between Obasek and
the Romulans. Cool, Robin Masters.
Sela's forces may indeed be hounding the Riemanns, but the use of Thaleron weapons is unacceptable. Not even the Klingons or the Breen will stoop to such
cool,
barbarism.
I get Scorpion fighters.
Starfleet Intelligence will be working to decode the list of possible targets you acquired from the base's databanks. The next step may be to investigate these sites and find out why the Riemanns want to destroy them.
So you get experience points, expertise, and Scorpion fighters. These are devices, not hangar pets. And some dilithium ore. And continue. Alrighty. So this has been The Vault. With Teacher Kirby and Beard. Say bye, Beard.
Bye, Beard.
Alright, and I'll see you next time for Mine Enemy.